Gurdarshan Mangat and Toni Tauru, brought to you by Rose Garden Hotel Yangon. High left roundhouse kick from Gurdarshan early on. So much hype, so much talk for Gurdarshan Mangat, the BFL amateur champion. 9 finishes as a pro.
Toni Tauru's got to be careful coming in like that, throwing those shots. That's how he got knocked out by Viviano Fernandez coming forward.
And Viviano Fernandez, the coach of Gurdarshan Mangat. Tauru, those long arms. Well, Finn can finish, but so too can Mangat. Now we got the grab for the first time. Post up on the left arm. Back to his feet now, Toni Tauru. It's been a long time between drinks for Toni Tauru. Good start here from Mangat Gurdarshan.
Tauru's catching a lot of those kicks. It may have been a year and a half since he's been in the cage, but he said that time away really allowed him to get involved in coaching, working with a lot of his athletes, and getting better as an athlete himself.
Toni Tauru, Cage Warriors bantamweight champion. Gurdarshan Mangat, BFL champion. Two more great martial arts champions in the cage here. 7 world champions on tonight's main card. Out of over 120 martial arts world champions on the one championship roster. Which are your head? Uppercut short in there. Missed the target for Tauru. Good range on that. Left cross out of southpaw stance for Gurdarshan Mangat. Saint Lion, they call him. A roundhouse kick from the Cage Warriors bantamweight champion in the red. BFL champion on the outside. Circling away from the power side of Tauru, wisely so from Mangat. Looks in amazing condition. Does Gurdarshan Mangat. High up on the balls of his feet, the chin is tucked, looking through the brow, went for the inside thigh. And how Tauru would love to get him down, would love to play the ground game. Good two-punch combination there for the BFL champion, Gurdarshan Mangat of India.
Nice left hand landed by Mangat. He's able to find a home for it. Tauru's got to be careful coming in like that. He's got to keep his chin nice and tucked. Follow that jab.
Ooh, trying to come over the top with a short right hook to Toni Tauru there. Cage Warriors champion threads a jab. Gets out of the way of the liver kick from Mangat. Mangat sticks the jab in the throat. Goes to the inside thigh. Double left hand there from Mangat. Flying knee from Toni Tauru. Uppercut from Tauru. Oh, nice takedown there from Gurdarshan Mangat.
Omoplata attempt here from Tauru. Let's see if he can use it to get back up. You can see the omoplata there, the shoulder lock on Gurdarshan Mangat.
Was it dangerous to take down a finisher on the ground like Toni Tauru?
This is a new weight division for Toni Tauru. I was a little bit worried when I heard he was dropping to flyweight. He spent a long time. He spent 6 years as a bantamweight. And to come all the way down, to have somebody like Gurdarshan Mangat on top of you is a tough proposition. But so far, Toni Tauru is a bit more active. He's actually looking good at this weight.
The former Cage Warriors champion, Toni Tauru, the BFL champion. Gurdarshan Mangat. Mangat moving well, switching angles between a southpaw and orthodox. Gets out of the way of that long-reaching jab from the Finn. There's the right hand from Tauru. Muay Thai clinch and knee from Mangat. Mangat circles away from the power side, away from the right leg, the right hand of Toni Tauru. Mangat caught him coming in, tries to fold him in half with a knee. Good work on the inside for the BFL champion.
Nice combination by Mangat to end up in that clinch and then throw that knee.
More than 120 martial arts world champions on our roster of 500 plus athletes here at one championship. Mangat fires the left hand, whips upstairs with the high roundhouse kick. Tauru says, try to touch me on the beard if you can. Inside leg kick from Gurdarshan Mangat. Neither man wants to give up center cage here. No signs of ring rust on the Cage Warriors champion, Toni Tauru.
Yeah, Tauru's looking really active at this weight. He's got it, he's nice and light on his feet. He's a lot more active when in the stance. He's throwing a lot of those, flying knees. This is a new Tauru. I like the reinvention of the Viking.
Lots of head movement from Tauru, sitting behind the shoulder. double jab, high left roundhouse kick there from Gurdarshan Mangat, the BFL champion, the Cage Warriors champion.
Here's a little bit of action. There's Tauru missing with the straight right hand, but then Mangat came back with almost a Stockton slap, answering with a shot of his own. Again, you can just see Tauru is consistently pushing forward. There's Mangat ducking underneath Tauru and ending up on top.
On debut, number one Indian mixed martial arts star, makes his first appearance in ONE Championship, the biggest martial arts organization on the planet. Fake there from Mangat. Up on the balls of his feet again, the Indian. Cracks to the outside, back thigh. Tauru reaching with the lead hand. Mangat changing levels, goes the inside thigh. There's the left hook. Mangat in great shape, ripped, stripped and striated. Look at the size of the delts and the traps on Gurdarshan Mangat, the BFL champion.
Gurdarshan showing good head movement here in the second round. Nice and light on his feet, moving that head off of the center line, not staying in the middle. And he's shifting his head away from the power side of Tauru.
Tauru, who's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu Finnish champion, hasn't had the chance to show us much of the BJJ styling so far, Mitch.
You know, he had that opportunity. As soon as Gurdarshan took him down, he was immediately attacking. He shows that pedigree and why he is a BJJ champion is the attack with Adam Plata. As soon as his back touched the ground, he was attacking. Tauru's got a very dangerous guard. No head kick there, landed.
Double leg takedown attempt there from Tauru. Didn't get him down. Bold uppercut from Mangat. Back to their feet. Center cage. 3:40 remains. Second round of three. Mangat in southpaw stance. Resets as the Indian, the BFL champion. Inside leg kick from the BFL champion. Now the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu champion in the red would love to get him down and tie him up like a Finnish pretzel. Body shot there from Gurdarshan Mangat. Double jab, roundhouse kick, nicely done from Mangat. Doubles up on the left leg roundhouse. Almost fell into a high knee there from the Cage Warriors champion.
Mangat's having a better round here in the second. He's been a lot more active in the punches.
Overhand right didn't come close there for Tauru. Circles off as Mangat thrusts the jab. Roundhouse kick for the four rounds. Another one from Mangat. Striking contest here in the second round. Good counter right hand there from Tauru. The BFL champion Mangat circles off to his right. Throws a good left hand out of southpaw stance. Tauru, lots of head movement. Using that shoulder protection again. A very side-on stance for the Finnish BJJ champion, Cage Warriors bantamweight champion. The BFL champion with the inside thigh kick. Jab to overhand right there from Toni Tauru. At what point, Mitch, does Toni Tauru's corner tell him, go for the takedown, use what your main strength is, let's get Gurdarshan Mangat on the ground and try and sub him?
I think he has. He's tried a couple of times to go for the takedown, but every time he's tried the takedown, he's been stuck. Mangat's been able to put him, stop the sprawl, really push the head down and get away. So Tauru's having a hard time committing to the takedown now because he's getting punished for it. And every time you do try something, every time, because takedown defense is a category of our scoring.
Jab from the Finnish BJJ champion. Long reach on the arms of Toni Tauru, returning to the cage after a long absence. As we said, showing no signs of ring rust against a man of ONE Championship debut, Gurdarshan Mangat of India. High kick, good double forearms guard there from Mangat. 1 minute 10 remaining, second round of three. On what has been a thrilling night of action here in Yangon, Myanmar. Up next, of course, we're in Tokyo for the first time ever on March 31st.
1 minute left in the
world title bouts on the one night. The biggest card in history goes down at the Kokugikan in Tokyo on March 31st. Plus, add to that, the one debuts of Demetrius Johnson and Eddie Alvarez, plus Andy Sauer versus Jotun Clive Fairtex, the most stacked card in history, Mitch.
A new era, Tokyo, Japan, March 31st. But right now, we're seeing a high-level display of striking shown by Mangat. He's starting to wake from the power. He's landing a lot of shots, and it's causing Toni Tauru to switch legs and actually switch stances and get that, because Mangat is just beating that leg up.
BFL champion circles off to his right, gets out of the way of the front kick, tries to fire the left cross, goes to the inside thigh. Final 10 seconds of the second stanza. Looping right hand there from Mangat, very wide southpaw stance now on the Indian. Jab from Tauru.
In this round two, look at that nice head kick. Barely Tauru was able to get his chin up. But again, look at this. Was able to get the takedown, but immediately Mangat pushes the head away, slides the foot out, slides that right leg out, immediately gets back up.
John, will it be a successful return for Toni Tauru? Will it be a victorious debut for Gurdarshan Mangat of India? And now we feel a bit more gusto, we feel a bit more pepper. They've upped the intensity here, Mitch.
Yeah, the boss came out and told them that they needed this to finish the match in this round. They got 5 minutes to put it on them. So, and they're actually, they're trying right now. They're throwing hands.
Outside leg kick there from Mangat.
Oh,
there's a left hand from Mangat. And he dropped Tauru. Tauru sprung back to his feet, but here comes the Indian. Here comes Gurdarshan Mangat. And he drives down Tauru. Top position now.
Oh, that's smart by Mangat to hurt him on the feet, drop him with the left hand, and then to swarm all over him and get that takedown.
Top position for Mangat.
But I think Toni Tauru actually is, that's in his favor. He's able to recover now. He's gonna be able to clear the cobwebs out from that big shot that Mangat landed, which dropped him. And now he's in his world. Now he can start working the guard.
And Mangat, oh, he skips around to the back of Tauru. What's he gonna do from here? The Indian, he tries a knee. Look at Gurdarshan Mangat, the confidence flowing now. He's done the damage to Tauru. Tauru locks onto a leg. Hammer fist strike, it's all over.
I want to see that left hand again. Watch this left hand. Mangat slips back, boom, right on the butt. Crumbles Tauru. And then the veteran, the kick kicks in. He chooses to take Tauru down. Going into Tauru's world, jumping knee up against the cage, and then just starts dropping the hammer fists.
For your winner, by way of knockout, Gurdarshan Mangat!
Southpaw stance here on the wrestler Roshan Mainam of India. Left of screen, Hong Sichan, the Kung Kumai stylist from Cambodia, right of screen.
Southpaw stance is going to put Roshan right in that position for a nice single leg off the lead leg of Kung Si Chan. See how long he chooses to stand with the
Kung Si Chan. Fancy early on here from both these men. Looks for the outside thigh kick to Kung Si Chan. Edging forward, Si Chan, right hand ready to throw here. Also right roundhouse kick. Which way he transfers his weight at the moment. It's out of the way of that round kick to the inside leg.
Kung Si Chan did spend this camp working with a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, Fernando Salvador, in Cambodia. It's okay to get put on his back just like that. Let's see what he's like in that guard position.
Big double leg takedown early on from Roshan Mainam. Not where Kung Si Chan wants to be against a high-class wrestler. All-time Delhi State Wrestling Champion who was selected for the Junior World Championships, Roshan Mainam.
You can see he's kind of got that arm sort of locked up there in a rear naked choke style grip. I think he's just trying to apply a little bit of pressure. He might be able to use this as a sweep. If he has that butterfly hook on the right leg, like he can take his right leg and just kind of put the foot on the thigh, he might be able to use it as a sweep. But you can see Roshan is just slowly starting to inch past that leg. So Kung Si Chan's got to be very careful about letting this half guard go, because side control is one of Roshan's most dominant positions.
Roshan Mainam, 3-2, one knockout, two submissions, 100% finishing rate as a pro. Also went undefeated, 7-0 as an amateur. Now goes to side control, very bad spot here for Konsichar.
And he's applying a lot of pressure, driving that shoulder into the chin, easily steps over into mount. So this is a bad spot for Konsichar to be in with over half the round left. Roshan's going to try to posture up now, maybe try to separate that grip and just drop a little bit of ground and pound on Konsichar, soften him up a little bit. This isn't the best strategy for Konsichar. He kind of wants to put the feet on the hips, start bucking, create that movement so he can initiate some sort of scramble. Because when you're dealing with a wrestler like Roshan that's got these kind of hips, he's going to spend a lot of time on the wrestling mat, so his hips are going to be really heavy. So it's going to be hard for Konsichar to buck up and create that movement.
All of Konsichar's losses so far have come in the first round. They've all come by submission. Once he tapped out to strikes, once to an armbar, once to a rear naked choke. Still Mainam in the full mount here. Once the 2 minutes remaining, first round of three.
Once Roshan kind of gets that space, he starts attacking the submissions. You can see him looking for the Americana, which is a key lock or a shoulder lock off one of the arms. So Konsichar's got to be very careful, giving up these limbs, and he just went after one just like that.
And that's a great win for Evolve MMA. For Roshan Mainam, and most of all for India. What a power India is becoming in one championship. Just unearthed another future star in Roshan Mainam. 23 years old, and he keeps intact his 100% finishing rate. Very impressive from here. Double leg takedown that drove Konsichar to the canvas early. And from that point on, it was total and utter dominance for Roshan Mainam. Put that left arm home with him. Konsichar, no place to go but to tap out. Ultra impressive indeed from Roshan Mainam. Big win for India. Great victories for the likes of Arjun Bula back in Tokyo in October. We're also going to see the one championship debut of the awesome Lintu Fulga coming up shortly. In a couple of weeks' time, Indian martial arts is certainly experiencing a boom period at the moment. There is another man who is all a part of it, Roshan Mainam. Now has three submissions in four wins and one knockout for that 100% finishing rate. BJJ blue belt. Used a mix of the wrestling and the Brazilian jiu-jitsu tonight to claim an early victory. Another first round submission loss for Konsichar. That is four first round sub losses for the Cambodian. Great way to kick off the night for Evolve MMA. Shine out of Singapore these days. We'll be in Singapore in a couple of weeks' time for one championship in the Singapore Indoor Stadium. And let's go to Dom Lau now and enter this one into the record books.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Motohiro Tsurura, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 22 seconds in the first round for your winner, by way of arm lock, Roshan Mainam!
One championship, Masters of Destiny. Southpaw stance on the Indian, Gurdarshan Mangat.
We saw a very smooth striking style from Gurdarshan Mangat on his debut against Toni Tauru. Let's see if he can keep that same slick striking style. Landed a nice little foot to the face there of Alvaro Fernandez.
The following that Mangat has in India is just unbelievable. Television coverage, radio interviews, newspaper and magazine articles, they are all over Gurdarshan Mangat.
Good takedown defense from Alvaro Fernandez right there.
Somersault roll throughs there. Mangat launching the high kicks early on. So far, Fernandez has ridden them. Inside leg kick there from Mangat.
Mangat looks very energetic. Nice and light on his feet, moving around quite well. Nice body kick landed by Alvaro Fernandez right there. He's got to be careful with that high kick, though. It's the third time Mangat's tried to go up top with it.
Good counter right hand after the high kick, though, from Abro Fernandez. Does have power in his hands, Fernandez. That's where he'll do the damage on Mangat. Mangat faking. The height, the reach. Big size differential in favor of Gurdarshan Mangat. Kicks to the back leg of Fernandez. Then goes to the lead thigh.
You can see the difference in their overall stances. Gurdarshan Mangat's nice and light on his feet, on the balls of his feet, moving around nicely, trying to touch Alvaro Fernandez. Fernandez is a little more flat-footed, trying to wade into that power shot, trying to get ready to land those big power thumping shots.
Catches the kicking leg, does Gurdarshan Mangat. Is he going to sweep out the support? No, he doesn't. Back to a striking contest. Jab two there from Mangat.
Fernandez showing good balance, though, when Mangat catches those kicks. Hasn't quite dumped him down.
Fernandez says he doesn't believe the hype of Gurdarshan Mangat. Good. Says he'll prove the naysayers wrong tonight. Rushes forward with the hands as Abro Fernandez. Mangat inching forward. Throws a nice left hand down the tube, followed by a leg kick. There's a right hand from Fernandez, smacked back with a kisser. Good outside thigh kick from Mangat.
You can see the way Mangat's coming forward. He doesn't really respect the hands yet of Abro Fernandez. But that's the second or third time that Fernandez has caught him with that right hand, so that respect slowly might be earned. And we might see Mangat start to be a little bit more tentative coming in like that.
Kick again from Gurdarshan Mangat. You saw Fernandez look to sweep out the support leg. Outside leg kick, nice little step across with it there from Mangat. Returns the favor as Abro Fernandez. Both men fake. Southpaw stance on Gurdarshan Mangat, aka Gary St. Lyon. Open with the jab, setting the high kick perhaps. Thought about it off the lead leg.
Action.
Jab two outside leg kick there from Mangat. Leg kick again, that one below the knee to the gastrocnemius. Inside leg kick from Fernandez. And again. Decent striking contest here. Two combination. Hook to an outside leg kick, not connecting though for Gurdarshan Mangat. 120 remaining, Dragon.
You can see Fernandez just trying to time that right hand, waiting for him to come in. I'd like to see him keep working that inside leg kick just like that. Just keep going to it over and over, slowing down that movement of Gurdarshan Mangat.
Fakes and a nice inside leg kick from Gurdarshan Mangat. Hard on the ball, he's been very agile. Is Fernandez sitting back waiting for a chance to skip on the inside of Mangat here, Mitch?
You can see he's patient. But he is constantly on his back foot. He's letting Gurdarshan Mangat control the action, control where this is taking place. But I like that inside leg kick. It's starting to slow down. You can start to see that lead leg is not quite the same from Gurdarshan Mangat. He's even thinking about switching stances. Fernandez needs to keep going to that inside leg kick, maybe even go a little bit lower and attack that lower part of the calf, like you said. The gastrocnemius, is that what you called it?
Gastrocnemius. Southpaw stance, Gurdarshan Mangat. One way to slow down an opponent's boxing is to take out their legs, kick the legs repeatedly. Good inside thigh kick. Every great punch, of course, starts from the feet.
See, now you're starting to see Gurdarshan Mangat reach down for that leg kick. He doesn't like the way that leg kick is touching him, so he's starting to reach down for it. Now I'd like to see Fernandez go up top. Look at Mangat coming in, going up top. Look at that, wrapping that foot around the head of Fernandez. Fernandez, though, kept his wits about him, used it for a takedown, tried to get him to the ground. There's Fernandez coming forward, landing a nice little right hand there, just trying to earn some respect from Mangat. But that's what we're seeing. We're starting to see that forward pressure from Mangat and that counter striking of Fernandez. I'd like to see Fernandez keep going to the leg kicks, but I also like to see Gurdarshan Mangat, who's a very skilled jiu-jitsu practitioner, maybe threaten a takedown, shoot in, just test the waters a little bit with a takedown, see what happens down there. We might see a change of strategy here from one of these guys in the second round.
One.
Sold out inside the Axiata Arena in stunning Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Top of one championship, Masters of Destiny. If you're watching it over 140 countries around the world, hope you're enjoying all the action just as much as we are. Big inside far kick there from Gurdarshan Mangat.
Mangat answers with one of his own inside leg kicks.
Fernandez wants to turn on the power with the leather now. Big looping punches from the Indonesian. Overhand right, the headache maker.
Mangat's getting caught with his hands down at the end. Reed comes in. You can see he comes in with a combination, and his hands are down around his waist. And that's when Fernandez is touching him.
Fernandez has big clubbing hands on him. Gotta be careful, Mangat. Not to lower the guard, not to offer the chin as a target.
And Fernandez has got a really good chin. Chan Rotano was landing some bombs on him. And he shook him off. Keeps going to that inside leg kick.
That's off the ring movement a little there. Does Gurdarshan Mangat goes to the inside left thigh. Then goes up to the ribs. Working the roundhouse, kicks the Indian. Overhand left being the rear hand of the southpaw. 3 minutes 40 remains. Second round of three. Our judges scoring on an overall contest, not round by round. Stiff left hand there from Mangat.
I like that left hand there thrown by Mangat. He's really applying a lot of pressure, and that left high kick is scoring over and over again.
Just feel he needs a little more torque, a little more pivot to really turn over that roundhouse kick and loop the shin around the back of the neck of Abro Fernandez. Inside leg there from Mangat Dragon.
Just this pace that Mangat puts on his opponents is tough, man. He kept this up the entire time against Toni Tauru, and Mangat was suffering from some nasty food poisoning. He was still able to power through it. Do not expect Mangat to slow down in this match at all. What we are seeing is we're starting to see Fernandez start to fade a little bit, slow down a little bit.
And Gurdarshan Mangat capitalize on the rapidly depleting gas tank, it seems, of Abro Fernandez.
Fernandez abandoned those inside leg kicks, too.
Left hook there from the Indonesian, the boxer. Outside leg kick with a step across from Gurdarshan Mangat. Resets. Good footwork here.
Not seeing combinations coming from Fernandez anymore. The longer this match goes, the more in favor of Mangat it's going to be, especially when he starts piecing up that leg. And that's that target that he's going for over and over on that inside leg from Fernandez.
Mangat's corner. Trying to continually come forward on Fernandez as he tries to land a question mark kick. Outside leg, tenderizing the lead thigh, the quadriceps. When he turns the leg, he hits that sciatic nerve, the hamstring area.
But I like the strategy, hand combinations to the inside low kick and then setting up that left high kick.
No attempt at a takedown here, no attempt to turn it into a ground game dragon.
Yeah, he's having a lot of success, Mangat is, at least right now. He's starting to land at will. You can start to see Fernandez is slowing down, and Mangat's still nice and fresh and light on his feet.
Mangat skips forward, lands another outside thigh kick. It's all point scoring for Gurdarshan Mangat. Fernandez tries to dig deep, tries to rally. And you see the mouth a little open here on Abro Fernandez.
Dangerous, especially when his left high kick's coming. He's got to make sure he keeps that right hand glued to his face.
When your mouth is open, you're more prone to getting knocked out.
It's just this work rate coming from Mangat. He doesn't slow down. He just keeps up this pace the entire time. Conditioning is second to none.
Looping right hand there from Abro Fernandez. 30 seconds remaining. And it's Gurdarshan Mangat on the Indian in control. Fernandez will need to go back to his corner, get some much-needed instruction, and find a way to really turn it around and offer something different in the third and final. He's slowed down. The gas tank is emptying out on Abro Fernandez. Gurdarshan Mangat, who comes in on a four-match winning streak dating back to February 2018. And we've got one more round to go.
In that early part of this second round, we could see Fernandez doing some good work, but you can see he took the inside leg kick, comes back with a nice little left hook there, barely missed with the right hand, but then Mangat just took control, you know, really putting a lot of different combinations together. There's Fernandez's better shot as he touched Fernandez on the chin there, but this in round is very important. Look at Mangat, not even taking the stool, standing the entire time. That is a superiorly conditioned athlete right now. And it's gonna be very important. I don't think he's gonna be satisfied just driving out a decision to win. I think he wants the finish. I think he wants to make a statement here in the flyweight division that he is truly a contender. But to do so, he needs to finish Albo Fernandez here. And he needs to finish him emphatically.
Third and final round. Gurdarshan Mangat, 14-2, five knockouts, five submissions on his record. And he finished Albo Fernandez. Fernandez 7-1, three knockouts, three submissions. The inaugural One Pride MMA Bantamweight Champion defended that title three times, also at Kempo Brown Belt.
Good head movement coming from Fernandez. As Fernandez tried to come back with a shot.
Coming off the first loss of his career, Fernandez last time to Chandler Thana back in December. It was a TKO in the second round. Before that, a tremendous streak dating back to March 2015. And again, as Mitch said, you see the output, the volume, the work rate. It's never ending from Gurdarshan Mangat.
He just really puts combinations together, and it's not just one shot. You can see that Fernandez is trying to just land that one big shot, which at this point is what he needs to do. But Mangat is beautifully putting in combinations. He's going from the head to the legs, mixing things up, mixing all kinds of weapons. We're just not seeing any takedown attempts.
You can never rule out Abro Fernandez, the boxer, because even if the gas tank goes, he's got that one big power shot in his fists. He can hit you. And if you get hit, you stay here. There's a left hook from Abro Fernandez. High left roundhouse kick. Inside leg kick.
There's a nice right hand by Fernandez. And got wobbled back a little bit. Says, yeah, you got me. My turn.
Three minutes remaining in this third and final round, India versus Indonesia. Big wild right hand there from Abro Fernandez.
You see, Mangat's not there to be answered. Puts the combination together and then slides out.
Jab two outside thigh kick from the Indian. Oh, smack back! Fernandez had a flurry and it just fell short.
You can see the left hand. I'm starting to wonder if something might be wrong with Fernandez's left hand because he's almost slapping Mangat with the left hook. He's not quite fully committing and stepping in with the left hand. He's just kind of slapping him with it.
Warring with that left hand at the moment, Abro Fernandez. Mangat backs out of the way, the right down the tube. Jab, oh, high kick!
He might be trying to parry the hand down as he's slapping him with it, but I think he's actually trying to slap him.
2:05 remaining in what has been a back and forth contest. It's been all stand up. No attempts to take to the ground. A glorified kickboxing contest. Jab there from Fernandez. Inside leg. Two punch combination from Gurdarshan Mangat.
Let's go, look to finish.
Fernandez tries to sweep out that lead leg just below the thigh, the inside of the knee. Outside leg kick from Gurdarshan Mangat. 1:35 remains now. Has Abro Fernandez got what it takes to dig down deep, find one big tub thumping right hand, one big leaping left hook?
Might be able to just step forward, throw that big right hand, but he's trying with it. Mangat's got good head movement, keeping that head moving. Fernandez is landing his own shots, though. They just don't look that really like they're landing heavily because, A, the left hand is sloppy on that. And the right hand, you can kind of see that Mangat's kind of riding the punch. And so you can see that he kind of moves with it. And so it kind of lessens the effect of the shot.
45 seconds to go. Portions of the crowd are chanting for Gurdarshan Mangat of India. They'd love to see a finish. Inside leg kick from Fernandez, chops the hands back. Gurdarshan Mangat can't capitalize. 30 seconds to go.
In the final round.
Tornado kick, and Fernandez saw it come and stepped in.
Jumping knee! Getting airborne, the Indian. And there it is. We've gone the distance here in Kuala Lumpur.
So you can see Abreu Fernandez, he was trying to come in. There's that nice inside leg kick. But then Fernandez, he was able to touch. He was able to put hands on Mangat. But then Mangat was just constantly moving and just had a higher work rate, plain and simple. There he is doubling up. It was just the combination work of Fernandez. Here he is trying to go airborne, and Fernandez just inches away from sleeping Mangat. But a very good performance, a very entertaining performance from Gurdarshan Mangat.
Will it be a victory to Gary St. Lyon, Gurdarshan Mangat, or will it go to the black kimono, Abreu Fernandez? Let's find out and go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Gurdarshan Mangat.
Mainam, one of India's fastest rising stars, and Liu aiming to deliver on the promise he showed when he became the one Hefei flyweight tournament champion when he was just 19 years old. Liu returning after a 20-month layoff. Will there be any signs of ring rust on Liu? On One Fantasy, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, playing now on the One Super app, 55% of fans favor Liu Peng Shuai for the victory over Roshan Mainam. Mainam in the white here, Liu Peng Shuai in the black, in southpaw stance. The man from China looking for victory number 7, 6-4 record, a 100% finishing rate for Liu. Also 100% finishing rate for Mainam, who holds a 4-2 record. Nice 50-50 split on the finishes. Three knockouts, three subs for Liu. For Roshan Mainam, one knockout, three submissions dragon.
Watch the back of the head!
This is what I was waiting for. I was waiting for Mainam to get in tight on that takedown. He's a wrestling specialist. He's got a very heavy top game. And you can see Liu immediately starts attacking with the elbows and ground and pound from the bottom position. Mainam needs to slow that down, get control of those hands, and start looking for that ground and pound.
So many big things mooted for both of these two young men, 24 years old, each of them. Roshan, who is out of Singapore these days from Team Evolve MMA. Liu, based out of Beijing, China, at the Fighting Brothers Club. Keeps up a couple of centimeters in height, gets caught with the right hand as Roshan, as he came in there. Some hammer fist strikes to the side of the head and the clavicle from the Chinese athlete, backed against the circle wall. Throws a nice little corky knee and gets out of dodges. Roshan Mainam tries to land the hooking punches. Liu goes the outside thigh kick, looking through his brow here, trying to cut off the movements as Roshan does a nice job of scooping away that lead leg front kick. Probing jab to front kick to right hand from Liu Peng Shuai. Good overhand right, doubles up and it does Roshan. Back to center circle, Liu with the uppercut, almost a bolo punch, came from low. Round kick to the ribs he saw there from Roshan Mainam. We do expect this one to go to ground at some stage. So far, both men content to trade in the standout. There was a nice right hand a moment ago down the tube from Roshan Mainam. Good pace to open up here, Dragon.
Yeah, Mainam's trying to get off with that right hand. He's throwing it very aggressively, and he's also looking for the takedown. But you can see that Liu kind of expects the takedown to come. And the way that Mainam's kind of grabbing him, he's kind of grabbing him around his waist. He's got to attack those legs and get nice and deep on that takedown if he wants to slow him down. But a big roundhouse kick just landed for Mainam.
You will see the better strikes coming from Liu. The kickboxer, very fluid, very accurate striker. Yeah. Roshan Mainam's going to start to shoot him for the takedown soon. And there's one, just as I say it, driving takedown of the canvas from Roshan Mainam. Inside of half guard, can he posture up here? Inside the full guard now. Good right hands from Mainam, the ground and pound. Back to his feet, drops the right hand to the jaw of Liu Peng Shuai. Nicely done from Roshan Mainam, Dragon.
Yeah, Mainam did a beautiful job of sweeping out the support leg and attacking the legs on that double leg. And he was able to put Liu on his back. But Liu's very active from the striking from the bottom. And he's able to work his way back up to his feet. You can see the breathing is getting kind of labored on Mainam. So this is not a good indication as we're ending the first round.
Liu has gone 3-2 in his last 5, 6-4 in his last 10. This is where he prefers to be, but as I said earlier, very even split, 3-3, 3 subs, 3 knockouts in his 100% finishing rate. Mainam does prefer the subs. 75% of wins, finishes, I should say, by submission for Roshan Mainam. Again, looking for the ground and pound. The up kicks here from Liu. Roshan tried to power through again with the right hand. Liu keeping him at bay, the feet on hips here of the Indian. Final seconds of what has been a blistering pace in this opening round to kick off one championship reign of dynasties. We are coming at you live from Singapore, and we thank the amazing Singapore government making sure that everyone is safe and everything goes off without a hitch tonight. And so far, we are loving all the action, Mitch.
See, when Mainam's able to get nice and deep on those legs, he is successful on the takedown. But Liu is having success with the striking. Not that time. That time, that roundhouse was all Mainam as he landed a beautiful high right roundhouse kick. But you can see after the takedown occurs for Mainam, he creates that space to try to find the ability to land ground and pound. When he does create that space, Liu is very active. He immediately starts kicking away to create the space, and then he starts landing strikes, so he's able to work his way back up. I'd like to see Mainam kind of control him on the ground, really get that good control, but it's gonna come down to the takedown and who has the bigger gas tank as this match progresses, because these guys are exerting a lot of juice.
You saw the corners go to work on their respective athletes. They are like the pit crews in a Formula One race. They have 1 minute to tend to their athlete. You saw the end swell, the cold press under the right eye of Roshan Mainam, sustaining some damage to that orbital in the first round. You saw the Vaseline applied on the T section along the brows and the bridge of the nose of Liu Peng Shuai. And here we are on the second of three. Our three judges circle side are scoring as an overall contest and not round by round. Good double right hand, make it 3, make it 4 there. And an uppercut on the inside from Roshan Mainam. Good right hand again to the temple. Mainam, who is built like a brick hit house, is landing the leather early in the second round, Dragon.
Yeah, it's coming from that right hand. He likes to double and triple that right hand up as he's marching forward, trying to engage in that clinch, thinking about taking it to the ground. But this is a very entertaining matchup. We are seeing a contrast of styles, contrast of game plans, and Roshan Mainam is starting to play out his blueprint perfectly.
Liu Peng Shuai is used to finishing opponents in the first round. He's had 5 first round finishes, so going into a little bit deeper water here is the Chinese athlete. No signs of ring rust, though, after that 20-month layoff due to an injury. But there is concern every time that Roshan comes forward with those hands so heavy to the jaw and temple, because half of Liu Peng Shuai's losses have come via knockout. Looking to go to side control now. Roshan Mainam gets there. Can he mount the Chinese athlete? Does so. Well done from the Indian, Mitch.
Yeah, beautiful guard pass to end up in side mount. Floated beautifully right over into full mount. And now he's dropping that ground and pound. This is where that control is going to come in. Can Liu start to scramble? Can he start to get away? Or is Mainam just going to drop these hammers on top of him?
Roshan is a 4-time Delhi State Wrestling Champion, IAMMA Amateur Flyweight and Bantamweight Champion, has the back, trying to flatten him out here like a pancake. Can't quite get there though. Gonna try and loosen him up a little more. Try and sink the choke now. Roshan Mainam going for the finish of the second round. Will he find it? Will he find it? Liu Peng Shuai defending, defending, and it's good night, Irene. That's a great win to kick off one championship reign of dynasties for the Indians. Roshan Mainam tapped him out in the second round, Dragon.
Wow, he brought the fire immediately. As soon as he was able to pass guard, he got on top and started dropping ground and pound until the submission presented itself. He snuck that arm right under the neck and then slowly started to apply the squeeze. You could see that Mainam actually defended the defense, so he was trying to peel the hand off of the top, and Roshan Mainam shoved his hand away and then sunk that choke in extra deep. You can see it right underneath the chin, and there was no place for Liu to go except to tap his way home. Beautiful performance from Roshan Mainam.
The 4-time state wrestling champion maintains his 100% finishing rate. Beautiful submission from the back. And Liu Peng Shuai had to tap out. Tremendous start. Let's go to Tom Lau to make this one all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohammed Sulaiman, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 27 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Roshan Mainam.
A 100% finishing rate for the man in the white trunks from Evolve MMA. Good outside leg kick. Snappy jab early here from Aziz. Nice jab from Aziz. You see the length advantage, the reach advantage in both the legs and the arms for Aziz Kalim. Inside leg there for Roshan Mainam. Moves in, clinches up, hopes for the takedown to negate the karateka.
Oh, good job by Kalim to pummel in and just get that a little bit more neutral position here as Mainam starts to press him up against the circle wall. Kalim's got to dig that underhook in and get him up above, but because that's what's going to happen. Once Mainam gets those hands locked, it is so difficult to stop him because he's got such an aggressive wrestling game.
Even though Aziz is a karateka, he does have 2 submissions on his record. So he can also perform well on the ground, as is Kalim, but at the moment he's in Mainam territory. It's Roshan land.
Position.
Kalim's got a very active guard. He likes to throw up submissions from this position, but he's gonna have to be very careful because Mainam's got such aggressive ground and pound. Once he gets on top, he does not just sit there. He likes to stay busy. And then he starts to work to pass the guard as well, to get past the legs of Kalim. Kalim needs to make sure he keeps his legs in front of Mainam.
Roshan looking to improve his position, go to half guard here. Always so impressive in the opening round, always brings the aggression, does Roshan Mainam.
Look how he pins down that leg, Michael. Mainam immediately starts to work to get past the legs of Kalim, and he's already about halfway there. He's just gonna slowly start to slide his knees right through the guard of Kalim.
3 minutes remaining, 2 minutes down. First round set for three of this flyweight contest at 61.2 kilograms. Kalim would have liked to have kept it standing a lot longer than it did. Was finding the range with that beautiful telescopic jab of his and the outside leg kicks before Mainam took him down, and Mainam seeks to take the back and gets there. Can he find a choke here on Aziz Kalim with a lot of time remaining in this first round?
Oh, that was slick, that's Michael. The way Mainam made him turn and give up his back was a thing of beauty. Now he's got the full back control of Kalim. Kalim's got to protect his
watch
neck.
Watch the back of the head. Watch the back of the head.
Hooks are in, flattens him out like a pancake. It could be the beginning of the end here for Aziz Kalim.
Catch.
He taps out, it's good night, Irene! Roshan Mainam's done it again! Another first round finish! This man is rampant!
Wow, he gets another victory inside the circle, Michael. Check this out. The way Mainam had that leg pinned down, there was nothing that Kalim could do, and then he just floated right over into the half, forced him to give up the back, and then once he got the back, he was patient, he was calm, and then just slowly eased that arm right underneath the neck. Look at this, he forces him to go face down, flattens him out with those heavy hips, and watch his left hand just slides right underneath the chin. Beautiful technique on that rear naked choke. Write that down, take a picture, because that's a wrap, ladies and gentlemen.
Tremendous performance again from Roshan Mainam. Continues his streak of first round finishes and maintains a 100% finishing rate.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee has called a stop to this contest for your winner by way of submission, Roshan Mainam!